Have you ever wondered why the aircraft carrier's island is always on the starboard side? Or what is the flight deck made of? You will learn this and other interesting facts from this video. I'm Radek Grec from Explained, and this is how the aircraft carrier's flight deck is arranged, based on the Nimitz-class vessels. The shape. Early aircraft carriers did have straight decks. The problem with a straight deck is that when landing, if the hook does not engage an arresting cable, the aircraft is going into whatever is beyond the landing area, usually other parked planes. That's why net barriers were installed on the deck to help solve that problem, but they usually damage the aircraft. With the appearance of jet aircraft, which were heavier and faster, a straight deck became impractical. The solution was the angled deck, which brought a lot of benefits. It allows planes who miss the arresting cables to take off again without the risk of smashing into another plane. It also allows for maximum potential of space to be used during cyclic operations. In other words, it gives the carrier the capability to not only launch and recover aircraft simultaneously, it also provides the capability of launching multiple aircraft at the same time. The surface. The Nimitz-class carriers use a laminated armored steel flight deck about 2 inches thick. On top, it is covered with an additional non-skid coating to provide traction for aircraft and tractor tires as they move around the deck. It does wear off over time and needs to be replaced occasionally. This anti-skid coating is resistant to fire, jet blasts, grease, gasoline, jet fuels, and other hydraulic fluids. The whole carrier's deck is covered with these shallow bowl-shaped depressions, with crossed steel bars across the top. They are called tie-downs or pad-eyes. They provide an anchor point to chain aircraft and other equipment to the flight deck whenever they are not under the positive control of a pilot or a brake rider. This is a safety measure in case the ship runs into rough seas, preventing the aircraft and other equipment from sliding from its position. They are constructed to be flush with the deck, so that when they are not in use, they do not turn into speed bumps. You may have more than one aircraft being tied down to the same pad eye. The landing pad. The carrier is designed such that landing pad is always angled to the left, with the conning tower or the island on the starboard side. To understand why, we have to go back in history. Every propeller-driven airplane produces a lot of torque whenever a lot of power is added. And because most single-engined aircraft have a clockwise rotating propeller, this torque causes the aircraft to turn left, and it needs a lot of pilot-induced rudder to keep it going straight. If the island was on the port side, the aircraft going full throttle on wave-off would have a tendency to go towards it due to the engine torque. Thus, it was far safer to have the island on the right side, so an aircraft on wave-off would be less likely to hit it. With jet-powered aircraft, this was not a problem, but props flew on aircraft carriers long after the jet age. On Nimitz-class carriers, the landing area is 800 feet long and 80 feet wide, and it's tilted at 9 degrees to the rest of the ship. The center line of the landing area is painted white and yellow, and from stern it extends down vertically, assisting the pilots in aligning the aircraft during final approach. The arresting gear. 4 steel arresting cables, also known as cross deck pendants, spaced about 50 feet, span the landing area. The aircraft's tail hook connects to one of these cables on touchdown, holding the aircraft to stop in about 300 feet. The cables are made of braided steel strands with a polyester core for flexibility. Cables are numbered 1 through 4 from back to front. Although there are four cables, the visual approach aids are calibrated so that the aircraft will catch the three wire on a well-executed approach. Each cross-deck pendant is removed and replaced after 100 arrested landings. They are supported a couple of inches above the deck by a lift spring that can flex, allowing aircraft to taxi over the installed wire. The barricade is an emergency recovery system that is used only when normal arrestment cannot be made. Physically located between the 3 and 4 wires, the barricade is normally in a stowed condition and rigged only when required. To rig the barricade, it is stretched across the flight deck between the stanchions, which are raised from the flight deck. Rigging the barricade is routinely practiced by flight deck personnel and should be accomplished in under 3 minutes. The catapults. All modern US Navy carriers have 4 catapults. Catapults 1 and 2 at the bow and 3 and 4 at the waist. The waist catapults are so named because they are amidships and thus cannot be used during landing operations because they fall the landing area. However, Cat 4 can have an aircraft ready to hook up for launch between recoveries. After flight operations, a rubber gasket is placed in the catapult to keep the debris from falling inside. There are several lines on both sides of each of the 4 launch catapults and both sides of the recovery area. These white and red lines define the minimum area that must be kept of obstructions in order to consider the deck clear, and are called the fall lines. It's a line that you do not cross at certain times during flight operations. JBD. These panels are called jet blast deflectors and are installed behind each catapult in order to deflect high-speed exhaust produced by launching aircraft's engines. Each JBD consists of 6 independent sections that are made of heavy-duty materials and is raised upward at a 50-degree angle by hydraulic cylinders or linear actuators. They are in very close proximity to a temperature of 2300 Fahrenheit, and because of that they require frequent maintenance or replacement. Additionally, the hot deflector surface cannot be used as normal decking until it's cooled down. To mitigate this problem, an active cooling systems are installed that use seawater circulating through water lines within the deflector panel. The bubble. Modern US Navy aircraft carriers use the Integrated Catapult Control Station, ICCS, which was introduced into the fleet in 1975. The station, also known as the bubble, permits additional safety and increased efficiency in carrier launchings. It is the focal point of the catapult control system, which eliminates various remote stations and their required intercommunications during every airplane launch. The bubble is air-conditioned and it's made of bomb-proof hardened steel. It can be retracted into the flight deck and it's only installed aboard the Nimitz-class aircraft carriers. One bubble is located between catapult 1 and 2, and the second one is situated on the port side of the carrier left of catapult 4. The bubble is occupied by the ICCS operator and the shooter who monitors the topside personnel and hits the launch button. The elevators. There are 4 giant elevators which move the aircraft from the hangar to the flight deck. Each can hold 2 aircraft or about 150,000 pounds of equipment. However, from lesson learned from the Nimitz-class carriers, it was realized that a 4th elevator turned out to be redundant and therefore only 3 elevators were left on the newer 4th-class carriers, which improved the flow of aircraft, weapons and fuel around the flight and hangar deck. In addition to the 4 main elevators, there are several small ordnance elevators located around the flight deck. Space arrangement. With a full complement of the air wing, the aircraft cannot all be stored on the hangar deck, which is used mostly for maintenance. There are several parking spots for the aircraft and equipment on the deck, Some have specific names associated with them. If bad weather is expected, the crew will try to move as many aircraft as possible under the deck and move the remaining aircraft to a part of the flight deck that provides the greatest shelter from the salt spray coming off the bow. But in general, most of the aircraft are kept on the flight deck. In addition to parking spaces for airplanes, there is also a special place for equipment on the carrier. It is called the junkyard and it's located right next to the island. This is where the tractors, fire engines, crane and all the handling equipment is parked. And finally, the area between the island and the rail, which is known as the bomb farm. It is a place where bombs and missiles are stored during flight operations, and from there they are brought to the aircraft. This was just a brief explanation of the most vital flight deck components. Other places like the island, meatball, LSO spot and other stuff will be covered in future videos. If you like this type of presentation and would like to see more, please support this channel by leaving like or comment. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching and see you next time.